inside this 3-star motel, this what really creeped me out up here by the front door. Not this. See the latches, bro. This what freaked me out. Right by the front door.
Hey, bitch.
Metro Boomin want some more, nigga.
So one of my favorite movies of the past few years is the movie Us, and something that's always stood out to me about this film is the opening scene. Text appears on a black screen and reads, "There are thousands of miles of tunnels beneath the United States, abandoned subway systems, unused service routes, and deserted mine shafts. Many have no known purpose at all." Now I'm gonna be real, this shit got me jazzed up when I first saw this movie. Like, what a lead up to a film. And I got even more excited when I found out that this statement is actually true. Deep below our feet are miles of infrastructure, abandoned projects, and tunnels just lying there, unseen and unthought of by the world. But my question is, are these structures really abandoned, or is there something sinister happening below us? In the early 1900s, the city of Cincinnati, Ohio, aimed to become one of the first cities in the United States to create a subway system. Tunnels were dug in preparation for its creation, and by the mid-1920s, the entirety of the tunnel was dug and solidified. The project was so far along that station platforms were even built, and at this point, it seemed that Cincinnati was on the cusp of becoming a model city for rapid transportation. However, just as things started looking up for the project, it all came crashing down. The Great Depression made funding for the project impossible, and the money ran out before the tracks were ever laid. The project was abandoned after this and left to rot below the city that once bet its future on it. The nearly 3-mile abandoned subway station is currently the largest of its kind in the United States, but it is nowhere near the only one. The Great Depression and other economic low points caused major cities in the US to abandon their subway projects for good, leaving the half-completed projects to rot. Now today it is believed that a solid percentage of the abandoned infrastructure below us is made up of these subway tunnels. And when you have these abandoned subway systems and abandoned tunnels beneath the earth, it's not like you can just fill them up and get rid of them. I mean, trying to demolish them at that point would just be dangerous to anyone living above them. So for that reason, many of them remain there to this day, completely forgotten by society. So for me, this is a terrifying thought. Just the idea of these big tunnels just below us with no purpose and being totally unguarded. Like, it is very unsettling to think about. But when it comes to abandoned underground infrastructure, there is much more than just subways. In the mid-1800s, gold was discovered in California, sending the nation into a frenzy. The gold rush brought hundreds of thousands of people from all over the country to search for their fortune and the Golden State. But as many would soon find out, the gold rush was well overhyped, and there was not nearly enough gold being discovered to sustain the huge influx of people. Decades later, many of the mines set up to find the gold were decommissioned and abandoned much like the subway projects discussed previously. All in all, 47,000 mines were left abandoned in California alone just because of this gold rush, almost all of which are lying dormant there to this day. So again, a little unsettling that these structures are just kind of there still. But to me, this is nowhere near the creepiest structures that lie below us. During the Cold War, the anxiety of a nuclear attack gripped onto the nation. With this in mind, thousands of fallout shelters were created below ground, some of which big enough to fit thousands of citizens within their walls. Obviously, the fear of a nuclear attack has since subsided, and this has left these shelters with little to no purpose at all. It is believed that over 200,000 of these shelters were left from the Cold War alone, with many more being abandoned from other points in history. And these shelters aren't just like little doomsday shelters. I mean, the size of them was crazy. Like, I was reading about one example where there was a full school underground in case of a nuclear attack. Now, these examples don't explain all the infrastructure below us, but it does give us an idea as to why at least some of it is there. But the truth is, some tunnels were dug with no purpose at all, and some had hidden intentions that the public could never know about. But what the majority of them have in common is the fact that they are all technically abandoned now. And with no one looking after these shelters, with no one guarding them, I'm left wondering if there are actually sinister things happening below us going completely undetected. The truth about this whole subterranean landscape is that there are so many unmanned places that people could be living in. And though the idea of people living underground may seem like a stretch, it is actually a very real thing. They're called mole people, and they are much more than just a fictional group. Mole people are described as being homeless people who are taking shelter within abandoned infrastructure underground. Not only have these people been written about extensively, but they have also been filmed multiple times and even interviewed in some cases.
Carlos? I got a message for you. We believe that Jesus is coming.
Oh yeah?
You have electricity. You're set up, so like no rent to pay, right?
That's a blessing.
And how do you get electricity?
You take it for all the way in the back.
Show me what you have in your fridge. Yeah.
Now for me, I would describe someone like this as a shallow mole person. This is someone who only lives a few feet below the surface and can easily access the outside world. And honestly, it seems like this wouldn't even be that bad of a thing, especially for a homeless person. But my question is, do these mole people travel deeper? Is there such thing as deep mole people? I mean, just think about it. This underground landscape is an unmonitored, lawless terrain. You don't have cops down there, you don't have rules down there, and you can get away with practically anything. And the deeper you go, the truer this sentiment becomes. So what's stopping criminals from moving into these hidden structures? I mean, it seems like this would be the perfect place for them. They can hide from law enforcement and also do whatever they want down there, including more criminal activity. And to an extent, this is something that has actually happened throughout our world before. In Europe, mob bosses have been discovered hiding out in underground bunkers beneath some major cities. Those who were eventually caught were able to hide without detection for years. So who is to say that the same thing isn't happening here in the States? High-end criminals could be hiding in bunkers, while low-level criminals could be hiding in abandoned subways. It's free real estate that doesn't leave a single trace and goes totally undetected. And the idea of this actually sounds somewhat sustainable to me. I mean, you hide below the surface for long periods of time, and you only have to come up when you need to get supplies. So you can stock up, go well below the surface, and never be seen by anyone. It is already known that some drug dealers have smuggle tunnels where they carry their drugs across long distances with little chance of being detected, proving that some of these structures are in fact used for illegal practices. But what about other criminals? Like murderers. In a way, these structures are a serial killer's dream. They can murder someone and hide underground, then travel for miles without detection to another spot to commit another murder and just repeat the cycle. You have a foolproof place to hide, and the tunnels would provide a hidden way to travel. Also, not to mention the fact that you could murder someone well below the ground and no one would probably ever find out about it. Now, for now, this hunch could simply be labeled as a conspiracy theory, because the truth is, I really don't have any facts to back this up. But I'm really questioning how this could not be true, at least on a small scale. I mean, if you wanted to hide from the police, why wouldn't you go below the ground where they would likely never find you? I don't know, am I crazy for thinking that? But another idea that I've become recently fascinated with is the idea that cults have been taking their practices underground in order to secretly practice their twisted faiths. Cults alone are creepy enough, and some that have extreme ideologies are disbanded after their beliefs reach law enforcement. So in order to avoid this, some have taken their cults underground in order to practice away from the reach of outsiders. In 2012, a cult had been discovered below the ground in Kazan, Russia. All in all, 70 people were discovered in an unheated bunker with no windows or contact from the outside world. The group had been hiding there without detection for an entire decade. Making this case even more shocking is the fact that 27 children were discovered along with the group. Each child was locked in a cell with no electricity and had lived the majority, if not all, of their life in this inhospitable condition. This case serves as a reminder of just how different the underground world is. If this had been happening above ground, the religion wouldn't last a day. People would catch on and the police would be all over it. But because it was underground, they were able to avoid detection for a whole decade. Now just picture this. Imagine if a bunker like this had been hidden in some farmland in some obscure state like Idaho. No offense. But if something like this were happening there, nobody would ever find out. I mean, it's just impossible to monitor underground like that. And if you really were that far away from society to begin with, and then took it underground, the world would never know. Now, although the idea of cults and murderers living below us is just kind of a theory of mine right now, this next idea is one that I'm pretty sure is true. Some believe that lying below our feet here in the United States are secret military bases set up to be completely undetectable so that classified information won't get out. Some believe these hidden bases are used to deal with extraterrestrial life. This is due to the high level of secrecy surrounding these bases. Their purposes and locations are completely unknown, but the secrecy surrounding them has led many people to believe that they are dealing with something big. Perhaps this is alien life, or secret technology, or just something completely new to us all. All that I know is that it makes me anxious just thinking about it. So with all this being said, here's what we're left with. There are so many abandoned structures below us that the majority of them are unmonitored and unthought of. The idea of murderers living here, and even cults calling these structures home, is something that has happened and may be happening here in the United States as we speak. Not to mention the likely theory that the US government has hidden bases below us, bases that have no known purpose. This all sounds scary, and in a lot of ways it is. We naturally fear what we don't know, and we really don't know anything about what's going on below us. But is this something that we should really be afraid of? Truthfully, I don't think so. Okay, sure, criminals may be hiding below us, but they're hiding for a reason. Chances are these people do not want to be seen and they want to be far away from society so that they don't get caught. And I doubt that they would run the risk just to randomly come by and murder you specifically. And as for cults, sure, the idea is terrifying, but it's kind of the same thing with the murderers. They're practicing down there to be secluded from outsiders. That's the whole point of them being there. Now, I'm not saying that wrongdoings aren't happening down there, because that may be a likely possibility. And that's certainly something that we should care about and worry about. But the selfish truth of it is that if you're watching this video, you're probably not going to be affected by that. Now, the one that still stresses me out is the idea of government bases lying below us. But it's one of those things, even if we had all the details about it, and even if we raised a big deal about it, we wouldn't be able to really do anything. It's interesting and it's creepy, but I guess at the end of the day, it's not really something worth stressing about. Sure, we can look into it, we can take interest to it, but I don't think it's worth being afraid of. So no, I don't think that we should be afraid of how this will affect us. And if you choose to stay above ground, then chances are you probably won't be affected by anything below you. But if you're brave enough to go underground and explore one of these abandoned places, just be wary of the evil that might inhabit them. And remember, there's a reason why this evil is hiding.
Shit, I got an elevator in this bitch.
Slick, come on.
That make your spine senses tingle.
What kind of shit is this?
Like I'm in the twilight zone now.
Don't let the back door hit you.
We gotta go.
Driving south to Colorado Springs, it looms in the distance. One of the most famous military bases in the world, Cheyenne Mountain. 1 mile inside the granite, 2,000 feet down from the top, it is a giant command and control center that has kept America safe for 50 years. Inside the mountain are 15 two- and three-story buildings. They are freestanding but connected by hallways and ramps. There is also a service area to keep the complex running, and even reservoirs, yes, underground lakes. You get inside by driving through a 2 mile tunnel, and when you get to the middle, you see the doors. The two famous blast doors that have kept the facility safe when they're closed. The door to this building weighs 25 tons and runs on hydraulics. It's usually open all the time, but if it is closed, oh, then there's a problem.
I mean, obviously Cheyenne Mountain was built to survive and endure through a nuclear event, and all of us hope that never happens.
The buildings behind those doors were built on 1,300 giant springs that can move independently if there's an explosion or earthquake. They would bounce, but they wouldn't break apart. And that's important because of what goes on inside those buildings. In control rooms like this one, which was set up just for us, experts keep an eye on possible threats. Everything from missile launches around the world to 23,000 objects in space. It includes satellites, the International Space Station, and lots of space junk. The original tenant, NORAD, the North American Aerospace Defense Command, is now headquartered at nearby Peterson Air Base. But it still has a command center here in case it's needed.
On the day that you hope never happens, the worst day in American history, their plan would be to come up here and operate out of here so that they would have that survivability capability.
As you can imagine, security for the control rooms is pretty tight. Our security escort said he can't even get inside them.
I can only fantasize about what goes on in there. Maybe a lot, maybe little, but whatever it is obviously important. So,
in the buildings underground, there are other facilities for the 300 to 400 workers. There's a cafeteria, appropriately named the Granite Inn. As everybody knows, it's not easy protecting the country when you're hungry.
Thank you.
There's an exercise and weight room because you can't just go work out at the 24-hour fitness during your break.
All right.
And if you want to find a pickup basketball game against a, say, short Jewish basketball legend, well, that happens too deep underground.
That's how we do it if you're in the mountain.
And since many people are in the mountain for long hours, a little shopette provides all the needed staples, like potato chips. All the comforts of home, sort of.
Whenever you're walking through the halls, it's not like, you know, you're seeing rocks everywhere. It's normal buildings, and so it's very easy to forget that you're underground. It's also hard to navigate in this building.
I get lost a lot.
To keep this all going, there are miles of pipes, cables, valves, and thousands of rock bolts to make sure the granite's stable.
As far as I've known, nobody has gotten hurt from loose rocks falling out and hit somebody in the head.
The place runs on Colorado Springs electricity, but there are 6 giant generators to back up power in the case of an emergency. There are 4 reservoirs, like this one, that can be used for cooling and drinking water.
Well, this reservoir is like 20 feet deep, and it holds about 1,000,005 gallons of water.
And a pet duck lives on this lake, but since it never moves or eats, we're guessing it's a rubber ducky.
I don't know the duck's name. You can give it a name if you want.
Cheyenne Mountain has been called America's fortress. The facility under Colorado is the eyes and ears of the U.S. defense system, watching and listening to what's going on all over the world and even out of this world to keep us all safe. What an awesome responsibility.
Yo, TikTok, I know a lot of y'all travel, a lot of y'all like to be on the road, and a lot of y'all get hotels and Airbnbs. But what I need y'all to know is this is a list of hotels. You got the Hilton, the Wyndham, the Days Inn, the Super 8, Best Western, Red Lion, Marriott, Choice Hotels, Extended Stay America, and Motel 6. What do all these hotels have in common? They're all being sued right now for human trafficking. They have been participants in human trafficking. But wait, that's not all. In some of these hotels, they have found tunnels in the closets that go underground that led to missing. Hey, do your own research. As you can see right here, the lawsuit has been filed against major hotel companies, including these, for allowing trafficking to occur from human trafficking. Also, these hidden cameras have been found in a lot of these hotels as well. The traffickers use these cameras to spy on you and to see who they can kidnap. This is a coat hanger. This is a camera that looks like a plain screw. You would never know. You have to check your rooms for cameras. Also, be aware of hotels that offer free shampoo and some conditioners because they're property and profiting from human trafficking. Also, containers will have shampoo in them, but the base of the container is a whole camera system. So be careful at Airbnbs and at hotels everywhere. You can actually buy a device that will scan a room and let you know if there are cameras in the room. And it will show you where the cameras are. And for reference, this is a hotel in Florida that had a hole in the closet that they went through and they found children way down that tunnel, where they would kidnap people that checked into these hotels.
Yeah, but inside this three-star motel, this was really creepy. I up here by the front door. Not this. See the last room. This was freaking me out. Right by the front door.
Trafficking now are fighting back now more than ever, and not just against the traffickers, but the businesses they say made their money off their own misery.
The hotel employees here allegedly ignored the red flags and visible injuries and cashed the profits from human trafficking.
This doesn't surprise me at all. The Marriott, Hilton, and other hotels sued over. So basically, these major hotels we support are turning a blind eye, possibly even involved. Here are some helpful tips to protect you and your family from human sex trafficking. Protect yourself from doxing. Post vacation pics when you get home.
Always travel in groups, never single. Don't leave kids in hotels if you don't know the staff. Never talk with strangers when traveling, and always watch your surroundings. Watch for people in hotel lobbies not to be followed. And move cautiously if any vans pull up by your car. Never, ever let anyone get you into a vehicle. Always use...
This is one of the most horrendous things that's happening in today's, you know, daily world that we have going on. Right?
Columbus attorney Stephen Babin says Ohio is the fourth largest state in the country for human trafficking, and more than 95% of it happens in hotels.
It's a problem that's been in the hospitality industry forever.
Babin has filed more than 40 individual lawsuits against six hotel companies, including Wyndham Hotels and Resorts, Red Roof Inns, and Choice Hotels International, for allowing trafficking to occur on their property and profiting from human trafficking.
We have horror stories where people are handcuffed to toilets and hotel staff comes in and nobody does anything about it.
The ability to yank the license if there are a significant number of police runs, if there's a significant number of violence and crime, if there is evidence of human trafficking that is persistent and not addressed.
Klein says he believes the owners should be held accountable.
They're the ears on the ground.
Somebody is conducting experiments on us.
It's been fucking chicken.
Shit in everything.
Great try.
The incident involving the Popeye's spicy chicken sandwich.
I see you bagging up. Don't push me.
This was at a mall in Nashville. Man repeatedly punches a woman after an argument while the two were in line. Now witnesses say she did shove that man first. This was just the latest in a string of violent incidents at Popeye's locations since the re-release of their spicy chicken sandwich. Last week in Columbia, Tennessee, an employee body slamming a woman to the ground, breaking six of her ribs, her kneecap, and shattering her arm. Anger management experts advise people step back, think about your actions before acting in anger.
Bernie Mac did speak out on a cloning. He did, he did try to do something about it. I know because I was there and I saw it, and it's pretty hard to talk about. I remember him with a scar in his mouth, telling us that we're gonna get out of here or whatever. He's gonna help people, and it's really painful to talk about because they killed him. And you don't see people down there that actually care. He had a heart. I don't know how he got down there. I don't know who convinced him, or what kind of pleasure, or vacation, or money, or whatever they put in front of his face, because he didn't belong there. He didn't have much to do with anything there. It's also interesting because I don't know what the fuck he was there, what he was actually doing there. But he couldn't basically perform the heartless acts of torture. And a lot of it kind of comes back to people being there that almost don't need to be there, that are kind of like drawn into it. And then everybody else, for the most part, is there and pretty much taking part in it. So it's rare that you'll see somebody not able to do that, but a lot of times you see people that pretty much don't want to be there and are just there because they have to. And a lot of times they'll get caught up in it. That's basically one thing I wanted to say there instead of beating around the bush. You don't dream up fucking memories like that, and they don't come back month after month. And then people across the world don't talk about them, doesn't have to do all this. These things that happened through history from World War II, the Nazi rules going over to Nazi scientists going over to Antarctica, and Admiral Byrd sending 4,600 Marines and then coming back saying UFO ships shot down his planes and chopped a warship in half with the laser. If that's all a conspiracy, then all of our history is just one big, you know, not a conspiracy, but a theory, and it's inaccurate, then all of our history is inaccurate, whether we think it is one way or the other, because our symbols all throughout history, all the way to ancient Egypt, you can look, you can see it if you open your eyes. That is the story. We were told, we were like debriefed, that's what they do to people. They just mess with you and show you the truth, and then if you don't tell people or if you don't do anything positive with it, they use that as proof to say, look at these humans, look at the people, even if they're not, you know, something else, even if there's people, they say, look at these people that they don't even fucking care about themselves. Basically, silence or inaction, according to them, is consent. And that kind of is. If somebody's in your house making a fucking sandwich, and you literally don't know this person, but you just go back to bed, don't say anything, you're fucking allowing it. That's how it works.
You keep your pimp hand raised and be willing to protect the ones you love by any means necessary.
I ain't scared. I'm a dope boy, remember?
Excuse me, kind sir, but if you could pull me to the elevator that leads down to the Fiki laboratory,
don't let the back door
I'll be out your atmosphere.
Let's get it, man.